So in this 40K podcast, I want to look at the progression of becoming a good player to a great player. And this is something that I started to crystallize and I started to see years and years ago playing at various tournaments where certainly Games Workshop is updating the various factions. They're putting out new armies. They're putting out new models. They're bringing in stuff from, I guess we'll call it the specialized games, where not only can you utilize those standalone, but pull them into mainstream 40K. But it wasn't always like this. Years and years ago, of course, Games Workshop would update Space Marines and some of the more popular armies. But for many players, Chaos, Dark Eldar, Tyranids to an extent, you were just out there, Sisters of Battle, you were out there in the abyss. You had your codex. There were no allies, there were no formations, there were no supplements. That's what you played. So what we had was this kind of tier 1, tier 2, tier 3, tier 4 armies. And certainly this still holds true today. But tier 1 was the most powerful codexes in the rules, in the units. I won't say auto win, but it was very hard to lose with these armies. Tier 2, the armies were still strong. Tier 3... they really weren't that strong. They had a lot of flaws in the rules. They had a lot of units that were not very good. We saw this with Tyranids. We saw this with Chaos Space Marines. And it was these Tier 3 armies that I would play against in tournaments, and a number of players would just be wrecking with it. They would just be destroying with it, especially against armies that I was playing Tier 1, Tier 2. I felt pretty confident with my Tyranids, with my Eldar, my Samhan Eldar, and I'm just getting destroyed. So what I started to notice, certainly, look, we all want to win, right? But when we lose, we can blame the dice, we can blame the tactics, we can blame the army. But in playing these lower tier armies at the time, my army was superior. My dice were okay. I was making the correct tactical decisions, at least in my mind, what I was aware of. So all of those crutches, all of those blames where it's like, this is why I lost, they didn't exist because these opponents were just decimating me on there. So I started to look and model. Modeling is an important thing in 40K. Often what we'll do, and this is natural, it's not a criticism, but the list, the units you're playing, how you're playing them, that is the currency, that is the vocabulary that we use to translate tactics back and forth. And certainly as you grow as a player, that's going to help you. That's going to help bring your game up. But at some point, we want to supplement that. And in looking at some of these players and modeling them, what were they doing? What were the tactics that they were doing? And I started to watch that. And I started to learn, and learn at a great price. The beating that I took across tournaments, and I'm going to their local meta and where they kind of hang out and playing them, it was worth the education. So Fritz, what did you realize? What did you see? I saw that these players, there were two things going on. There was a duality of two things. 100%, they knew their army in and out. They were divorced from the codex. They were taken away from the army list structure out there. They knew what they could do and what they couldn't do on there. And second, they knew their army so well that rather than calculating the odds or figuring out where to go and what to do and what was the probability, they could separate themselves from that and see the mistakes I was making on the table because they weren't thinking about their army. They were going on autopilot. Yes, the dice are going to swing and maybe things work out and don't work out, but they were able to capitalize on mistakes that I made. Now, in playing my own Eldar and in playing my Tyranids, I was not making major mistakes. I was not making major mistakes with this army, these armies, but I was making maybe micro mistakes, little things like not all of my units being in range or taking a gamble and saying, okay, look, I'm probably going to wipe out this unit. But if I don't, it'll expose me to return fire on there, and I really can't afford to lose jet bikes when they're 23 points a model on there. Little micro mistakes that accumulated over time. And then we're like at the end of the game, and I'm like, how am I losing to Chaos on here? And this wasn't even like dual lash with obliterator spam dropping the templates on there or Dark Angels. No disrespect to Dark Angels. Fourth and fifth edition Dark Angels were just awful. And this one Dark Angel player in particular, I mean, he's an amazing player, crushing me with Dark Angels. And I'm like, how is this happening? So how do we get there? First I identified it. I took that beating, multiple beatings, and I identified it. And I said to myself, okay, how do we get there? The first is just to play games. Just to play games. And in the beginning of 40K, winning is important because winning signifies to you that you're on the right path. I get that. And every time I play a new wargaming system, I feel that, right? You've spent all this time building, painting, collecting, learning tactics. You want to know that you're not wasting your hobby time on there. So if you win, you're not. That's true. But sometimes in forcing the win or going aggressively for the win, you win against most people on momentum and brute force, but you miss some of the subtleties of your army. So figure out what you want to play. This is kind of the template. Figure out what you want to play and stick with that list. Just play a bunch of games. Now, with that, this is my own personal idea in developing an army. I'm going to use my Samhan Warhost. I figured out at some point playing Eldar, I want to play Jet Bikes, I want to play Vipers, I want to play Wave Serpents. So at any given point game, 80% of my list is locked. I play the same thing over and over again. Jet Bikes, Vipers, Wave Serpents, some sort of support with Fire Prisms. It's not boring because I love these units. But we do want a little diversity. We do want to explore other models. I will build a list and hold off maybe 20% of the resources that I can swap things in. So maybe this time I'll play Dire Avengers in there. I'll load up on Dire Avengers. If I need super competitive, I'll go for Fire Dragons. Maybe I'll take Guardians in there. So you can get in other models and add them into your list, but they're not going to change the overall flow of your army. Because every time you radically change your army, now you've reset that learning curve on there. And that's not to say you can't have multiple armies and play multiple lists, but locking, loading, learning your list. Just play games. Just get games in there. If you see yourself losing, play the game out to the end. This is a chance to learn your units. Over time, you're going to find the focus of the table shifts from individual units to the army to you and your opponent's army on there. And now you'll begin to be able to see the possibilities of those mistakes on there and capitalizing on those mistakes. That is this kind of third point in there in 40K. I've identified 4 points in 40K. You come in, you're learning the rules. You don't have to memorize them. That's what your buddy's for. That's what an online resource is for. That's what the rule book is for. But getting to the point where you understand the base mechanics. I mean, look, I'm still looking stuff up. Although, in my defense, I have like 8 editions mashed into my mind, and sometimes it gets really, really hard on there. But becoming familiar with those rules, seeing how they work, seeing how they stack. Then, and that's not to say you're not playing your army and doing things, but that's the first focus. You know what the game can do and not do. Then you move on to building your list. What armies do you want to play? What units do you want to play? Do you want a themed list in terms of shooting or assault? Do you want to play a little bit of everything? Do you like the idea of fast-moving units? Do you want to play a horde list, an elite list, a mixed list? You're going to develop your player personality. There's no right or wrong in this. You're just kind of developing that. Then we move on to proficiency in that list. That's the third point. That's what we're looking at here. Till we move beyond to the fourth point, where you're on autopilot and playing it through there. That's where I'm always trying to go there. That's what I'm trying to do in all of my gaming systems. That's what I'm looking to do. And that's where you're going to catch people by surprise. Because we often make mistakes, myself included, that we're not aware of. Because I'm like, I'm so focused on doing this or doing that on the table, I don't even see the opportunity. But my opponent does. So play the models you want to play. Play the units you want to play. And let's get through and over that learning curve.